please give a warm welcome to Weird Al Yankovic.
We've been together for so very long, but now things are changing. Oh, I wonder what's wrong. Seems you don't want me around. The passion is gone and the flames died down. I guess I lost a little bit of self-esteem. That time that you made it with the whole hockey team. You used to think I was nice. Now you tell all your friends that I'm the Antichrist. Oh, why did you disconnect the brakes on my car? That kind of thing is hard to ignore. Got a funny feeling you don't love me anymore. I knew that we were having problems when you put those piranhas in my bathtub again. You're still the light of my life. Oh, darling, I'm begging, won't you put down that knife? You know, I even think it's kinda cute the way you poison my coffee just a little each day. I still remember the way that you laughed when you pushed me down the elevator shaft. Oh, if you don't mind me asking, what's this poisonous cobra doing in my underwear drawer? Sometimes I get to thinking you don't love me anymore. You slam my face down on the barbecue grill. Now my scars are all healing, but my heart never will. You set my house on fire. You pulled out my chest hairs with an old pair of pliers. Oh, you think I'm ugly and you say I'm cheap. You shaved off my eyebrows while I was asleep. You drilled a hole in my head. Then you dumped me in a drainage ditch and left me for dead. Oh, you know this really isn't like you at all. You never acted this way before. Honey, something tells me you don't love me anymore. Oh, no, no. Got a funny feeling you don't love me anymore.
Now, I guess I'll talk amongst yourselves for 3 or 4 minutes while Jim retunes.
So, Al, when was your last desk job, by the way?
My last desk job? It was 1982, I think. It was right before and during when I got my first record deal. I worked for Westwood One, which is a radio syndication company, which used to be based in Culver City, California. I'm not sure if it's even still there. I think last time I drove by, it was a Korean barbecue. I worked in the mailroom there first, and then I went on to a glorious desk job where I actually got to call up radio stations and make sure they were playing the spots they were supposed to be playing. And by then, I had actually a little bit of notoriety on the Dr. Domeno show. So I'd be calling up saying, hi, this is Al Yankovic from Westwood One. And, oh, are you the another one rides the bus guy? Like, yeah, that's me. Have you been playing your Trident spots? You know? No. So it's been a while since I've been behind a desk, so it feels great to be back.
So how many times a day are you asked to parody something? Like, you should do a parody of...
Every time I walk outside, pretty much. Or of course, somebody will have a great idea for me. Like, oh, Al, I've been holding onto this idea since the third grade, just hoping that someday I would run into you at the Ralph's in the frozen food section. We're good? I think we're ready for song number two. We like to call this next song, song number two.
Good old days.
Oh, that too, yeah, we'll call it that. Oh, sometimes I think back to when I was younger. Life was so much simpler then. Dad would be up at dawn, he'd be watering the lawn, or maybe going fishing again. Oh, and Mom would be fixing up something in the kitchen, fresh biscuits or hot apple pie. And I'd spend all day long in the basement torturing rats with a hacksaw and pulling the wings off of flies. Those were the good old days. Those were the good old days. Years go by, but the memory stays. And those were the good old days. I can still remember good old Mr. Fender, who ran the corner grocery store. Oh, he'd stroll down the aisle with a big friendly smile, and he'd say howdy when you walked in the door. Always treated me nice, gave me kindly advice. I don't know why I set fire to his place. Oh, I'll never forget the day I bashed in his head. Well, you should have seen the look on his face. Let me tell you now, those were the good old days. Those were the good old days. The years go by, but the memory stays. And those were the good old days. Sweet Michelle, she was my high school romance. She was fun to talk to and nice to smell, so I took her to the homecoming dance. Then I tied her to a chair and I shaved off all her hair, and I left her in the desert all alone. Well, sometimes in my dreams I can still hear the screams. Oh, I wonder if she ever made it home. I tell you, those were the good old days. Those were the good old days. The years go by, but the memory stays. And those were the good old days. Let me tell you, buddy, those were the good old days. Those were the good old days. The years go by, but the memory stays. And those were the good old days. Let me introduce the band. Jim West on guitar. Steve J on bass. John Bermuda Schwartz on percussion. And Ruben Valtierra, normally on keyboards, he's playing the egg. Good job. Good job.
Where's his red tambourine?
Oh, that's coming up soon. Wait. Thanks for the reminder. We're switching to the red tambourine. Now I was just told this is a haunted tambourine. Apparently, the woman who delivered this to the NPR offices, she was driving over here and she lost her car while she was driving it. I still don't understand how this works. But it's a haunted tambourine, ladies and gentlemen. So, fear the tambourine. Okay, the third and final song is something that's going to be on our next album. It was released last summer as part of the Internet Leaks Connection. Collection. It's a White Stripes pastiche, which we don't normally play with congas and acoustic guitar, but we're gonna give it a shot anyway. So this is a tribute to the icon Charles Nelson Reilly. Was a mighty man, the kind of man you'd never disrespect. He stood 8 foot tall, wore glasses, and he had a third nipple on the back of his neck. He ate his own weight in coal, and he screened diamonds every day. He could throw you down a flight of stairs, but you still would love him anyway. Yeah, you know you'd love him anyway. The Tour de France with two flat tires and a missing chain. He trained a rattlesnake to do his laundry. I'm telling you, the man was insane. He could rip out your beating heart and show it to you right before you died. Every day he'd make the host a match game, give him a piggyback ride. Yeah, 2 hour piggyback ride. Giddy up, Gene. Ninja warrior, master of disguise. He could melt your brain with his laser beam eyes. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! He had his very own line at the DMV. He made sweet, sweet love to a manatee. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! That was something to see, I tell ya. Charles Nelson Reilly sold his toenail clippings as a potent aphrodisiac. He ran a 4 minute mile blindfolded with an engine block strapped to his back. He could eat more frozen waffles than any other man I know. Once he fell off the Chrysler building and he barely even stubbed his toe. Had a tiny little scratch on his toe, didn't even hurt. Charles Nelson Reilly figured out cold fusion, but he never ever told a soul. I seen the man unhinge his jaw and swallow a Volkswagen whole. He'd bash your face in with a shovel if you didn't treat him like a star. Cause you can spit in the wind or tug on Superman's cape, but Lord knows you just don't mess around with Sienna. No, no, no. This is our best Tiny Desk concert ever. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yay. Well, after party.